In this video segment, I'm going to go through the process of creating custom hardware for cabinets. Specifically, I'm going to go through the process of drawing a line, converting that to a molding that you can assign a profile to. I'm going to then convert that to a symbol, add it to the library. I'll then place that symbol and resize it for different components of cabinets, small, medium, and large. And then it will be available in the library. Let's open up a blank plan and get started. The process of creating custom cabinet hardware begins by using your CAD tools to draw the initial geometry and then convert that into a molding polyline and assign the profile. I'm going to start by using a CAD rectangular tool. I'm going to come in here, draw the shape, and as I'm holding my left mouse button down, I'm going to press the tab key. I'm going to enter in the dimensions of 10 by 1.5 inches. If you're using the interiors version and the tab key is not enabled, you can always click on the different segments. And using your temporary dimensions, just click on that number and you can assign the exact dimension to it. I'm going to click on the back line. Use this tool called Disconnect Selected Edge, press the delete key. I now have three lines. I found using the rectangular line was easier and faster to get the exact dimensions to end up with this three-line segment. Next process is to highlight the line segment. In your lower edit menu, you're going to find a tool called Convert to Polyline. The option that I'll select is to convert it to a molding polyline. On the height, I'm going to enter in 36 inches. That way it's just showing off the floor when we take a 3D view. And then on the moldings, I'm going to look for a square profile. Under our core library, I happen to have one under the brackets. I'll select the square profile. And on the height and on the width, I'm going to set it to be 1/2 inch. The next process will be to assign a material to the hardware. I'm just going to place an existing cabinet, use the 3D camera. From the 3D camera view, I'm going to use the material eyedropper, pick up the pull material, apply it to our new piece of hardware. I can then remove the cabinet from the display. And underneath the tools menu, under symbol, I'm going to convert this to a symbol. From the drop-down, I'll choose Hardware. Let's go ahead and turn on the Advanced Options. For the name, I'll give it something descriptive. And then on the Sizing panel, let's go ahead and toggle on our display and rotate around. I'm going to end up creating a large and smaller version of this. I want my stretch plane along the Y-axis to be set so that it doesn't distort the two end pieces and just stretches it longitudinally. So I'm going to go ahead and enter in a stretch plane. Visually, you can see that beginning in X11. If you have a stretch plane turned on, you can always modify it. If you're using X10 and prior, you can just set the stretch plane at the original origin of 0. Let's go ahead and add that to the library. Notice it's placed right in the library with the same name. Back over in the plan view, I'm going to place two copies of this handle. And then I'm going to use the elevation camera back clip cross section, create a section through here. I'm going to stop short of the original hardware element we drew. To create the vertical version of the handle, I'm going to go ahead and rotate this. When you do this, it's going to ask you the question if you'd like to regenerate the 2D CAD block. Probably important since it's only 1/2 inch wide. We'll regenerate the CAD block. And now I have both the vertical and the horizontal. Let me split my screen and we'll make a couple of copies of this so we can make it both smaller and longer. So we'll go ahead and tile my views. And in the plan view, I'm just going to draw a marquee around the two elements, use the copy tool, I'll slide a copy over to the side, and then I'm going to use the same copy tool and slide another copy over to the other side. Now back in the elevation view, if I maximize this view, I'm going to make sure that my resizing works in 1-inch increments. So I'm going to double click on the Select Objects tool, and I'm going to turn on Use Snap Grids. Let's turn the grid off. That means it's going to snap in 1-inch increments. And if my temporary dimensions are turned on, and I want to resize this to 6 inches, it makes it pretty easy. So I'm going to go ahead and slide these down to 6 inches. We'll leave this one at 10 inches, our original. And then on this side, let's go ahead and make this. We need to make this 24 inches for the larger one, 24. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the vertical element. We need to make that 24 inches. So I now have a small, medium, and large pull handle. The medium horizontal is already added into the library. I'm going to go ahead and click on the small, add that to the library. I'll quickly add the remaining hardware pulls to the library for you. Now I've finished adding all of them. You can see the long, the medium, and then the smaller down here. Probably a good idea to create a folder and put these in and create your own custom hardware. I've done that previously. If you look at one of my folders, I have a cabinet hardware millwork folder, and you can see the different components that are added in here. Now to add this hardware onto your cabinet, from the plan view, let's place a cabinet. I'll just grab our base cabinet, click and place one off to the side, and before I go into the 3D view and apply the hardware, look at the scale on the smaller pole and on the larger pole. The scale is not accurate. I'm going to go ahead and click on the smaller one. In the lower edit menu, you're going to find a tool, Open Symbol. On the 2D block panel, I'm going to come down and I'm going to check Auto Generate. And you'll notice that the scale is now symmetrical on the front and side. Do the same thing on the larger one. Use the Open Symbol on the 2D block. Check the option for Auto Generate. Let's go ahead and go into the 3D view and apply that hardware. Let's go ahead and zoom in on the cabinet. And as you can see, we have the different components over here. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the medium vertical pole, click on the door, replace it. You're going to notice that it is now sticking up above the door. Let's fix that in just a second. Let's grab the horizontal pole, replace the drawer pole. That one looks okay. So I need to change the offset for the pole on the door. Let's double click and open up the cabinet. On the door and drawer panel, come down to the door handle. You can see down from top, my original simple knob pole was 1 3/8. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say plus 10 inches. Press the tab key. That will change the offset of it. And since I created a 10-inch pole, that should be in the same position. Close the dialog. And that's the process of creating custom hardware for your cabinets.